Tonight, Father, we want to give you glory because, Lord, you shaped us and changed us and made something happen this year that we didn't expect. Father, we trusted you for something and you have overwhelmed us with your goodness and your mercy. I think it's got to start somewhere about the fact that mentoring is one of the most powerful tools that our body has been given by the grace of God to disciple people, men and women, to become more Christ-like.
Your mentoring has been such an awesome experience.
I was really blessed with the prayer partners and building relationships through relating to other people's experiences. And
without them, this year would not have been possible at all.
About 2013, God spoke to me and it was almost like a warning. He said to me, be careful to stay connected to the people I've placed you with and in the position I've put you in. Or over a season of time, you're going to find yourself moved out and swept away. The word that God declared over this year was come up to the higher vantage point. And that was intentional so we would see what God could see over the situation and not to try and deal with the situation from the natural and from a carnal mind, but to try and get God's perspective from a spiritual place.
And I always thought, you know, I'm not an angry person, I'm actually super fun and joyful and happy and everything. But then when we did it that night, I realized that there was that thing called the internal anger, that passive-aggressive anger. And God really spoke to me about the pride in my life to think that I'm not an angry person, whereas someone else might be an angry person. But the truth is my internal anger is just as bad and just as much something that I have to work on, and that I can't cover my passive-aggressive anger with a fake joy, because that's a self-righteousness which is just a sin as well.
And the easiest way for me to deal with emotions was just to say that it's okay, and I've learned that it's not always just okay. We actually just need to pray and ask God to really show us what the condition of our hearts is.
And every time I met with one of the girls that are in the group, it was an awesome, awesome coffee time and prayer time and breakthrough time and sharing time. It was so rewarding. It was something I know that it is such a part of mentoring that you have to do. It's a special time of connecting hearts, God showing us, changing us, building relationships.
It's amazing, it's a journey. It doesn't end in June or July or August. It will never end. but that is exciting and it really makes me excited for the future.
It's just mentoring, it's just being joyful, it's just being breakthroughs and really just a peace and at rest to just be and be myself, and that's okay.
I'm so grateful because there's been so much change in so many women's lives through deep, intentional relationships and trusting one another to reveal what's in our heart and trusting God that under the blood it can be done. And in this past year, I buried so many of my personal family, my mum, aunts and uncles, but in this year, God added my heart to the family so deeply, my spiritual family, and for that, I'm grateful.